We give our praises to Yahweh Hashem Yahushai. Double honors to the apostle of great millstone that rule well. And salutation to the Akiam that preaching this word in sincerity and in truth. And also to our elder brother holding it down in America with the apostles also. We have brother Elijah coming out, our brother Asha coming out one more. One more time.
Can.
So let me read it over again. This is Isaiah 45 verse 4.
Yeah.
He said, for Jacob my servant's sake, and Israel my elect.
That's right. So Jacob, God made a covenant with Jacob. But even with Abraham, father Noah, he told Noah that he will make a covenant with him and his seed. You understand? From then on, until Abraham bring out Isaac, and from then, give the 12 patriarchs with Jacob. You understand? So this is how the Lord works. You understand? He done lay his covenant with our people, northern nation. Because that other nation was among us.
Right.
You understand? But the nation of Israel is God delivered. We are a chosen people unto the Most High God. You understand?
Let me finish it off. I have even called thee by thy name.
That's right.
What is the name? The name is Yasha Allah.
That's right.
Prince of power. Prince of almighty power. Bring it out.
Yeah,
I have surnamed thee. And though surnamed thee, though thou hast not known me.
That's right.
You say, why he said, though thou hast not known me? Is because we have been stripped from our identity,
right,
from our nationality.
Right.
You know, through the so-called white man, through the transatlantic slave trade. You understand? Brought here into captivity. Our sisters wearing weave and pants and don't even know themselves. And think the right and the wrong. You understand? So we know we stripped from our nationality, because if we knew we serve as Yasha Allah, then our sister wouldn't be wearing pants and I would not have to talk this way to them. But how to bring it all dusty and the Lord to them in anyway? Because they don't know themselves. Remember the operative owner, Isaiah?
Yeah,
bring
it up. Isaiah 1:3.
I'm going to bring out scripture, Yasha Allah, and prove that our people don't really know themselves.
That's right. We don't know ourselves.
You understand what I'm talking about? We don't know ourselves. And the days getting closer, we have to keep warming up our people.
Yeah,
beat it in the brain, right? That's how Christianity was beat in the brain.
That's
now,
right.
Now our job as the men of the Lord is to beat out Christianity out of the mind and bring in God's truth into the mind. Bring it out.
Isaiah 1:3.
Bring it out.
The ox knows his owner.
That's right. The ox knows his owner.
And the ass is master's
crib. And the ass is master's crib. Now these animals are dumb animals. You understand? But they know their owners. And even the ass know his crib. You understand? Go on.
But Israel
does never know. Israel don't even know who they are. Right now they're walking upon the face of the earth here and they're believing in religion. You understand? All different sorts of religion they fall in under. It's Catholic, Muslim, you name it. All different religion. But the heritage, they don't know their own heritage. And they have stored feelings and they call Muslim enough. The total feelings. Because why? They feel I'm Muslim, I say they are we up like this, we own for being Muslim. They waste our time. Muhammad never prophesied nothing.
You know?
You understand?
And to back up, Farrakhan, and he called a million man match, a time in America.
Yeah.
And a whole sea of Negroes, right? But at the end of the day, they went to the million man match, and at the end they said, go back to the ghetto as what, niggas, not so?
That's right.
They
have no redemption. It have no redemption when coming to these things. To being a Muslim and all these things. No redemption. Even Rasta, being Rasta, no redemption.
No redemption.
Because Rasta want equal rights and justice. Yeah. You understand what I'm saying? He wanted, imagine that. He wanted to be hung up and love up with a white man. I don't see the sense I mean. When God make we a superior people over this nation.
Deuteronomy 7:6.
Bring it out for me. Let me bring out them scriptures. Let me see who God choose over all the other nations. You understand?
Bring it out.
Amos 3:7.
No. Deuteronomy 7:6.
Hold on, we'll bring that.
Yeah, we ready to tell it there. Yeah, guys, that come on, man. Switch and pass.
Chapter 7:6. Thou art an holy people unto the Lord thy God.
Alright, so he said, the Most High said, thou art an holy people unto the Lord thy God. You understand? Now let me give me Deuteronomy 1 and 1. Let me find out who the Most High really talked to.
Who he was talking to.
Let me get it real and serious.
You see, because we get it in depth that he was talking to the children of
Israel. That's right.
And we get it in depth that we people still don't know each other even
they
in 2017.
Know. They don't know this exactly, God.
Especially down in the islands, Yashala. Especially down in the islands.
1:1 These be the words which Moses spake unto all Israel.
No, he said the whole world.
Unto all Israel.
So Moses was speaking, he gathered the people and them together, and he was speaking unto Israel. He wasn't speaking to the other nation, to the heathens. Because they were, what if I had heathens or that? Why is doing them?
Yeah.
The Egyptians didn't know how far. The Egyptians slew in all them other gods and other kings. They slew a whole nation. But God was speaking, Moses was speaking to who?
Israel.
Pray for that.
Right. 7:6
Now I'm the Lord. You don't have it yet? Yeah. And 6.
1.
2. Thou art the holy people unto the Lord thy God. Lord thy God has brought thee out
and chosen thee.
And chosen thee.
Yeah.
You'll be a special people.
That's right. So he chooses us to be a special. Imagine we're supposed to be so happy. And we're supposed to give our praise to Hawaii Shimmy every day for being a special people unto the Most High God.
I'm a priest here.
Go on, I'm
among all people,
among
all people.
Among all people.
Thou art the face
of the earth. It's simple. We're supposed to be so happy to know that, oh yeah, watch me, God choose we as a people. We above these nations and them, the Indian and them, they're going into slavery, thus said the Lord. So is the white man, the Syrian man. This why the Syrians up inside of here.
I have a precept for you.
You understand? We're supposed to be so happy. But instead, you know what's going on? We want to say, nah, we have to love them.
I have a precept for you.
You can imagine that. You can imagine that, man. How sick we people is.
Bring it over
here. I have a precept for you. This is Deuteronomy 4:5
Bring it out.
Behold, I have put you statutes and judgment.
That's right.
Even as the Lord my thy power commanded thee, he commanded me that he should do so in the land where that thou goest to possess it.
That's right.
Keep therefore and do them.
That's right.
For this is your wisdom and your understanding.
That's right. So the Lord gave us, he gave us the law, statutes and commandments so we can afford to learn how to live. The Most High set his laws upon the face of the earth. So we're going to know if we transgress the law, we're going to know when we sin. So we have to live by the law. So that is how we go gain. We have, that is why what make Israel have so much wisdom in. But we fail God daily.
Romans 15:4 Whatsoever things were written aforetime were written for our learning.
For our learning.
That we do patience and comfort the scriptures might have hope.
That scripture, that beautiful scripture, he brings out. He said, whatever was written for time, which means
for this time.
Back then was written for our learning and this time
that
we, who is the children of Israel in the end time here, may have comfort and hope in these scriptures.
Right.
That's why we can say Kwam Yashala.
Rise Yashala, man.
Because that is what it is.
That's right.
Yeah. I have a scripture here too.
Bring it out
there. He said, Isaiah 45:5 He said, I am the Lord and there is none else.
That's right.
There is no power beside me.
Exactly.
He said, I gird thee though thou hast not known me.
That's right.
He said, I gird Israel even though Israel have not known me.
Yeah.
Because the only people that had the oracles, the laws, the statutes and commandments was
Israel.
He didn't give it to nobody else.
He didn't give it to the Egyptians.
Somebody give him Psalms. You know the scripture?
Psalms 147.
Verse 19 to 20. You understand? We had the oracles. We had the oracles of the Most High from the beginning. You understand? The other nation didn't have it.
That's right.
The Syrians don't have it.
No, they don't.
Esau never have it.
At all.
The East Indians never have it.
That's right. That is why I just say, but these Egyptians and all too. What are you talking about Kemet and all these things? But what is black man redemption from Kemet? They have no redemption. They ain't telling you, well, here what's going on. Through Kemet, you'll find grace or you'll find salvation through Kemet. It have no salvation in Kemet.
None
at all. Yeah. But God shows that through the word of God, you will find salvation.
But you know, bozos like Shaka Amos,
oh God,
and Polite,
and Paul,
and all these, and these crazy, yeah, effeminate niggas, yes, wouldn't understand that. So what they do, they make it a duty to come,
yeah,
they make it a duty to come by the children of Israel,
yeah,
to try to prove something. Now, really actually, these niggas come coming to take our, what, to take information from us, that to try to see if they can build Kemet.
Yeah, yeah.
That's why we in GMS, the scripture say, talk not much with a fool.
That's
right. You know, don't talk much with a fool. Because these niggas are considered a fool. You know? I think Captain Tewan, I think Captain Tazarian just trying to talk to them, but hey, the scripture say, talk not much with a fool because they're a fool. He said, because you become like you're trying, you did the good part onto what? Slime.
Psalms 147. Verse
19, he showed
his word unto Jacob.
So the Lord Most High God showed his word unto Jacob. God.
The statutes and his judgment unto Israel.
Unto we as a and people. God.
He had not dealt so with any nation.
No, he did for everybody.
As for his judgment, they have not known
him. He never did well so with everybody. He did so with Israel. You understand? So Israel alone had the Lord's statutes and commandments. So we know how to deal with the Most High God. We had to walk in the light of God.
Yeah.
That's why when Yahweh Shai came, he didn't come and to say, well, he came to destroy the law. He came to fulfill the law.
Right.
He came to teach you how to live by the law.
Right.
You understand? He didn't come to destroy the law, as the Christians want to put it, that oh, the Lord destroy and the Lord done away.
And all that put it, that same Paul say, what?
The law was like an old schoolmaster.
Nah,
they don't have no knowledge.
Yeah,
that people, that is people who don't have no knowledge.
Yeah.
This is Leviticus 26:46. These are the statutes and judgments and laws which the Lord made between him and the children of Israel. These are the statutes and judgments and laws which the Lord made between him and the children of Israel.
He said, these are the statutes and the commandments which the Lord made between himself and the children of Israel. There was no Eastern there, there was no Chinese there, there was no Moabite there, there was no Edomite, none of them was there. It was just God and the children of Israel. So the notion that the Christian church pushed God so of the world, John 3:16 is just a misunderstanding scripture, or as we don't say, GMM, they become a stumbling block to the heathen. That is all. Yeah, it just becomes a stumbling block to the heathen. For them who don't know your how about you know what I, it becomes a stumbling block. Give me Isaiah 45:17.
Yeah, man.
Right?
Isaiah chapter 45:17.
Yeah, that's all it means. It's just a stumbling block for these Christians and these heathens thinking God so loved the world.
Isaiah chapter 45:17. Hold on, that chapter.
That's right, you see what people have to do for a living? Really garbage, man. The Bible says we shall come up very low, and the heathens will come up very high. That is what it is. That is what it is. Bring it out.
Yes.
Damn that garbage truck. There we go.
Yeah. This is Isaiah chapter 45:17.
Bring it out.
He said, but Israel shall be saved in the Lord.
But who?
But Israel shall be saved in the Lord with an everlasting salvation.
Somebody give me Romans 11:26.
Ye shall not be ashamed nor confounded, world without end.
Somebody give me Romans 11:23.
This is Romans.
Ye shall not be a confounded, world without end. You understand? God already said I love Jacob and I hate Esau.
Yes.
You cannot twist that and turn that around to suit your ideology.
He said, this is Romans 11:26. He said, and so all Israel shall be saved.
And so what?
So all Israel shall be saved.
So back up Isaiah 45:7, he said all Israel shall be saved. He said not in the least shall fall to the ground, which in the least he like. You understand, bro?
Yeah. As it is written.
As it was written where? Yeah. In Isaiah, in Old Testament. Go ahead.
There shall come out of Zion.
There shall come out of what?
Zion.
Where?
The deliverer.
The deliverer. Who is the deliverer? Yahweh Shai HaMashiach. Yahweh Shai HaMashiach. The Black Christ.